The following is a clip from my new comedy special, Secret Optimist.
I was never a dog person. I was never a dog person until I went on a date with a really hot girl and she was like, I love dogs. And I was like, you're hot, me too. And that's Darwinism. So now I have a dog. And I love him very much. And I've become an advocate in the rescue community. And I'm learning a great deal about dogs. My friends are trying to educate me, make me a better part of that community. One of my friends sent me a story that said there was a dog acting weird. And they figured out that their house is on fire just because the dog was acting weird. He sends me another story that says there was a dog acting weird, and they figured out that their kid had autism because the dog was acting weird. He sends me these stories. He's like, aren't these stories incredible? I said, no. These are the worst stories I've ever heard. Sometimes my dog acts weird. Now I need to figure out what the fuck is wrong. Terrifying that knowledge is every time my dog goes in a circle one too many times, I have to, like, do I have epilepsy? Or did I leave the stove on or my dog ate a grape? What happened? By the way, if you ever figure out that your child has autism because your dog acts weird, please pay more attention to your family. I think that's solid advice instead of using your dog as the check engine light of your household. I had one dog that was a weirdo. He was part Dalmatian and part Chihuahua. I know, that means something terrible happened. That's not romantic. What do you think, that was Romeo and Juliet? Just our love is forbidden because it's physically impossible. Like, no. A Dalmatian took down a Chihuahua. You get that, right? Or the most badass Chihuahua of all time climbed aboard, picked a spot, and went to town. My point is, he shouldn't even exist, but I love my little rape baby. I love him so much. It's not his fault. His dad was an asshole, but it's not his fault. I was hanging out with my dog. He's the best. He's a Staffordshire Bull Terrier named Walter Matthau. He's awesome. Yeah. If you're unfamiliar with Staffy as a breed, it's like a pit bull face on a pig's body. Yeah, he's a potato with feet. He's the best. And sometimes people are afraid of pit bulls because they're illiterate. Well, if you know anything about dogs, you know you're more likely to get bit by a small dog than a big dog. Anybody who has a small dog knows that. Anybody who has a small friend also knows that. But people will make that inane argument. Well, if it did bite you, wouldn't it hurt more because it's bigger? Yeah, probably. But we don't ban big people. They could hurt us more. I looked this up, the Netherlands, tallest country. People on average in the Netherlands are a foot taller than some other countries. And no one has ever said, don't go to the Netherlands. What if one snapped? They're nice people.
I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, you can watch Secret Optimist for free right here on my YouTube channel. And if you want to kick in a little something as a thank you, go to patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. Or check out a live show. My calendar is at stevehofstetter.com.